Find out what's going on. Get involved. Change things from the inside. Make a difference. Take pride. Multicultural at its best. The Luisa Marshall Show. Coming up.
Today, all news simply the best. On the show, Canada's Minister of Families, Children and Social Development, Employment and Social Development Canada, Minister Ahmed Hussen.
We are doing everything that we can to help the people of Ontario, including...
The minister discusses Canada's budget 2021 and its impact on Canadian families, especially to the Filipino community, over the following days ahead.
Well, two things. First, we have to continue to support Canadians as they deal with the impacts of...
And on Spotlight, Amarya Amro.
I chose Electric Love as my song is because...
And her amazing performance at the ACT Theatre. And some very special highlights of the Youth Talent 2021 in Maple Ridge, BC. Get ready to be inspired. All these coming up. Hello, hello, hello. The COVID-19 recession has greatly impacted the most vulnerable people in Canada. Many of them, women, low-wage workers, laborers, young people, racialized workers. It has affected many family-owned small businesses and their employees. We have the pleasure of having Canada's Minister of Families, Children, and Social Development, Employment, and Social Development Canada on the show. Joining us is Minister Ahmed Hussen to discuss Canada's budget 2021 and its impact on Canadian families, especially to the Filipino community, over the following days ahead. Minister Hussen, how are you doing?
Very good. And yourself?
I'm doing good. So excellent. I take it that you are in Toronto right now.
Yes, I am.
How is Toronto doing during this pandemic?
Well, you know, it's a challenge, but we are doing everything that we can to help the people of Ontario, including Toronto, obviously, with more supports. The Government of Canada continues to increase the number of vaccines, doses that we're bringing to the country. We're bringing millions and millions of doses. So we're doing everything that we can to protect Canadians. And Budget 2021 was also about that, to continue the supports for Canadians throughout this pandemic, and then to also invest now to build a strong and green economic recovery.
I like that. Green and economic recovery. So the COVID-19 recession continues to affect the most vulnerable. Yes. And lots of them are in our Filipino community because the hotels are closed down. Yes. A lot of other businesses are closed down. So what other measures of recovery are being done in 2021?
Well, two things. First, we have to continue to support Canadians as they deal with the impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic. So that includes extending the Canada Recovery Benefit. It includes extending the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy so that more businesses can continue to employ Canadians. It includes extending the Canada Emergency Rent Subsidy so that businesses need a little bit more help to pay the rent. So we're doing all of those things, but at the same time, we're investing in the future economic recovery after the COVID-19 pandemic. That means $5.7 billion for youth so that youth jobs can be created, 215,000 jobs. The Canada Student Grant being doubled, more supports for students, and training, skills training for opportunities for young people. So more supports for seniors, 10% more support in the old age security payments starting next year. And then this year for seniors, providing them with a one-time payment of $500. But the big piece in the budget 2021, is the plan to invest $30 billion over the next 5 years to create a Canada-wide system of early learning and childcare that will build an affordable, accessible, high quality and inclusive childcare system across Canada that will ensure that no child is left behind. This is really important. And for the first 5 years to invest the $30 billion, what we intend to do is bring down the cost, the daily fee of childcare down by 50% by the end of 2022 and bring it more down further by an average of $10 a day by the year 2025, 2026.
Yeah, I read about that, Minister. Most family business owned restaurants, especially here in Vancouver area, you know how it is, you know, the Filipino restaurants.
Yes,
and there
yes.
are mostly family owned.
Yes.
And some of them are companies like the cargo companies, LBC, the printing companies owned by, you know, Filipino families. But right now they are really merely hanging on to dear life, and it would take years to recover. And we all know that. Is there any new proposal to help these businesses for 2021?
Yes, there is. We're extending also the Canada Emergency Business Account, again, to help businesses access that capital, that support. But the key thing is also to invest now to ensure that we recover stronger, faster, and better after this pandemic. COVID-19 will not be with us forever. We're going to defeat COVID-19 together. And so the important point is, as we continue to support Canadians now, we also have to, at the same time, invest in the jobs of the future, invest in sectors, make sure that we have a strong economic recovery so that those businesses can not only come back, but actually become stronger.
Minister Hussen, staying away from the budget, I know we're talking about the budget, but right now I just need your personal opinion. Canada is struggling in the implementation of the COVID-19 rules and restrictions. The reason being, you know, the number of cases are going up. We are so surprised here in BC ourselves, because we started really good.
Yes.
But like yes. there in Ontario, it was just, you know, it was just the bomb of cases. But now we have a lot of cases. What do you think, in your honest opinion, is the best for our leaders, including yourself, to do to in order for this implementation to really
Well, I think it's important, and we've been saying this as the government of Canada, I think it's important for each and every one of us to do their part. Each and every one of us can do their part to follow the public health guidelines, because that's how we can keep ourselves safe, but also keep our neighbors safe, keep our community safe. It's really important. Don't engage in any non-essential travel. Practice social distancing. Wear a mask. Make sure that you're following the advice of the public health officials. And I think that is true now as it was true last year. So it is really, really important. And Canadians have been doing their part, but we just need to keep at it. We're almost there. We're going to defeat COVID-19 together.
Minister Hussen, one more question.
Yes.
Have you taken your vaccine?
I'm planning to. Hopefully this week, I'm planning to do that.
I know, me too.
Excellent, wonderful.
Me too. Okay, so let us just have a one last, is there anything that you want to say to the Filipino community of British Columbia?
Well, thank you so much for having me on your show. I mean, I really want to thank Filipino Canadians from across the country, including in British Columbia, for stepping up. There are so many Filipino Canadian medical professionals, essential workers, frontline workers, who are doing amazing work at keeping all of us safe, at ensuring that we are all fed and that we are taken care of. And so they're sacrificing to really help their fellow Canadians. And for that, I want to thank them on behalf of the Government of Canada, I want to appreciate all the efforts and I want to say thank you for everything that you're doing. And thank you to have this opportunity to talk with you. Budget 2021 is to continue our efforts as a government, to continue to invest in people, but also invest in the community, invest in infrastructure, making sure that we're doing the right things now to set Canada for a very strong, inclusive and green economic recovery.
Thank you. You are doing the right thing, Minister. Thank you so much for this wonderful pleasure.
And you're welcome.
I hope you can come back again to the show.
I will. Salama.
Have a good day.
Okay. Salama.
We'll be back with Amarya Amro. Don't go away.
Hi, my name is Amarya Amro. I'm 14 years old and I'm in grade 8. My hobbies are playing the guitar, singing, drawing, sketching, definitely painting, and playing volleyball, because that's one of the sports I do outside of school. And the thing I love to do the most is definitely play my guitar and sing. I do it all the time, and I love doing it. It makes me so happy. The thing that inspires me is seeing kids, like, just a few years older than me, pursuing their music career. It could be on YouTube, on TikTok, and any other social media platform. And I aspire to be that. Also, who inspires me is my entire family. I love seeing my aunts and uncles up on stage, like my mom and you and my aunts and cousins, because they have so much self-confidence and confidence to go on stage and dance or sing. And so I aspire to do that, and I would love to do that one day. My favorite artist is Tyler the Creator, and my favorite songwriter is Lady Gaga, because she writes such amazing songs, and I would love to write my songs like that one day. The thing I am doing during COVID is focusing on my studies, since I am homeschooled due to COVID, and I am focusing on my music all the time. I'm writing songs and playing on my electric guitar and my acoustic guitar. I play all my instruments, like my ukulele and sometimes piano. That's what I've been doing during COVID, as well as playing volleyball with my volleyball team. And yeah, the lesson that I learned during this pandemic is definitely the value of family. I value it so much more through the pandemic, because I'm so grateful that none of my family was harmed by COVID. And it's very awful that other families were affected by it and maybe even had some losses. And I feel very sorry for them. But I'm so lucky to have my family safe at home and nothing bad is happening to them. So I am so grateful. Yeah. One thing I could change in this world is definitely world hunger, because we have so many resources and so much food, yet there are so many children in the world starving, and adults as well. And we are not giving our resources to them as well. And I think that we should definitely do that, because it's they're suffering, and I don't think there should be suffering in this world as well. And it's hard for them through the pandemic as well. So that is the one thing I would change about this world. The thing I enjoyed the most about Roig Moore Youth Talent Show is definitely it being different this year, because there was no audience. There was only the camera guys and Clint. And it was definitely very different, but still very enjoyable. and getting to talk to them and like knowing new people, I think it's so great. The other acts were really great as well. I loved watching them. The reason why I chose Electric Love as my song is because I've known it since I was younger, and it's such a great song where you can sing your heart out while you're dancing in your bedroom or in the living room or anywhere. And that's exactly what I did. And I thought I could do my own version on the acoustic guitar, and I decided to perform that because I love that song so much by the artist Born. So yeah, and this is my video, and I hope you enjoy.
Good evening and welcome to the 2021 Youth Talent Show. Alright, let's also like to thank the ACT Theater for allowing us to showcase youth year after year during Youth Week. I hope you enjoy the show as much as I did. Have a good night.
And I keep on a knocking. Will there be smooth sailing? Cause I'm trimming my sails in my top hat and my white tie and my tail. Oh.
Got me debating if you are the right guy. If you are the right guy.
I knew there's something I keep from you. It's a quiet shot. Don't you feel like crying?
Hope you enjoy the show. Please follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Please don't drink and drive, don't text and drive, always be kind. Let's stop bullies and the coronavirus. Wash your hands, wear a mask, stay safe. See you next week. Bye-bye.